So you have started charting, or you've been charting for a while now, and you've come to the conclusion that you ovulate a little bit later or much later than the textbook cycle day 14, and now you are left wondering why. So shall we chat about what could be the underlying reasons for that? Hello lovelies, and welcome to another one of my videos in which we'll be talking about why you might be ovulating late. And this is actually a viewer's question by Aisha from India. She recently asked me what could be the reason that I'm ovulating late, and she's really not the only one, but she was the last one, and I thought, time to make a video. I will cover the five most common hormonal reasons for ovulating late and one non-hormonal. And these are not all the reasons in the world, but they are the most common, and they will point you to the direction of what's going on for you. But it is really important to actually interpret your chart properly, not just based on ovulation, but also based on your temperatures and other symptoms that you might be having. So if you're interested in me interpreting your chart, then make sure to sign up to my mailing list, because I occasionally run webinars where I am interpreting your charts. And especially now that I'm on maternity leave and I have no more fertility assessments available, sorry, the webinars are the best spot to sign up to get my eyes on your chart. And now before we go into the reasons of you ovulating late, we first need to establish if you are actually ovulating late. So that first of all means that you should be charting properly and not just using ovulation tests, because that doesn't tell you when you're ovulating. If you're not 100% sure if you're charting properly, then make sure to check out the video that I did on the topic, 3 steps to get started with charting. I will link it in the cards up here as well as in the description down below. Secondly, ovulating late is a bit of a broad concept, isn't it? Cycle day 14 has been considered the textbook ovulation day, but if you always ovulate on day 15 or 16, there's not necessarily a problem. And if you occasionally ovulate day 15, 16, or even day 17, 18, again, that doesn't necessarily mean that there's a huge problem. If you, however, always or most of the time ovulate later than day 17 or often don't ovulate at all, then I think it's important to look at the underlying reason. And lastly, I need to encourage you, if you're ovulating late, that doesn't mean you cannot fall pregnant. It just makes it even more important that you actually chart, that you're able to interpret your fertility signs so that you can identify when your fertile window opens and you can catch that egg. So the first reason that you might be ovulating late is that you have high testosterone. And the reason for this could be that you are struggling with PCOS or that you have hyperthyroidism. And these are two completely different conditions, but they both have the result of high testosterone that interferes with ovulation. So you might not ovulate at all. You may have anovulatory cycles, or you may be ovulating late. If you struggle with high testosterone, then it is quite unlikely that you will always ovulate on day 19 or always ovulate on day 20. It is more common for you to have very irregular cycles and to ovulate at different times, or as I said, some cycles not ovulate at all. If you already know that you have PCOS, make sure to check the PCOS playlist that is ever growing. I will link it up here, of course, and in the description. But if you're not sure if you have PCOS, some symptoms of PCOS are struggling with weight gain and also excess hair growth. Symptoms of hyperthyroidism are symptoms of a high metabolism. So you might get hungry very quickly, but lose weight very quickly. You might feel hot often, and you might perspire a lot, and you could get quite a bit agitated. And in your charts, you will generally see high temperatures. But it is important to get checked out if you suspect that you either have PCOS or hyperthyroidism, and not just go based on these symptoms, but they give you some clues of what might be going on for you. The second reason that you might be ovulating late is that FSH might be low. Now, we always fear FSH being high because it shows that menopause is imminent. Not completely true, but that's a different story. But if FSH is low, we have an issue too, because FSH is follicle stimulating hormone, and that is what matures the eggs. And as the eggs mature, estrogen goes up. Estrogen communicates to our body that the eggs are ready and that LH should be released so that the eggs can be released. So what you will often see is, if FSH is indeed low, that you will see signs of estrogen being low. And you can see that in your chart or in your fertility signs, by not having any cervical mucus, not having a lot of cervical mucus, or it's showing up quite late, or not getting any raw egg white cervical mucus. If you're wondering what could be causing low FSH, it's often because your anterior pituitary gland is imbalanced, and that can often be the result of taking contraceptives, so the hormonal contraceptives, whether that's the coil, injection, or the pill, or because you've been taking fertility drugs, or because you've had labor drugs in the past. And then not so much the epidural, but I'm talking about things that induce labor. So oxytocin, pitocin, syntocinin, however you wanna call it, wherever you are. The third reason that you could be ovulating late is that prolactin is high. I talked about prolactin in a recent video on Vitex, so if you are interested in that, make sure to click on the link in the cards up here or in the description down below, as always. But prolactin, we know as the milk-producing hormone, and it has way more functions than that. But the gist of it is, if your prolactin is high, it suppresses ovulation. And the reason that prolactin might be high for you could be you're breastfeeding. That could be a reason, or you're still breastfeeding a little bit. Another reason could be that you have low dopamine, and low dopamine is often the case when you're just not having enough fun in your life. So hey, that should be a quite easy fix if that is an issue for you. But I talk about the low dopamine relationship with high prolactin in that Vitex video as well. So if you're interested in that mechanism, make sure to check out that video or the blog post series that I did on Vitex, which I will link down below as well. And thirdly, is not as common, but it does happen, and it doesn't have to be something very terrible, but it's possible that there is a tumor pressing on your anterior pituitary gland. And as I said, it can just be benign, it doesn't have to be something terrible, but if that's the case, that does make your anterior pituitary gland produce more prolactin. There could be another reason that you're producing too much prolactin, and that has to do with another hormone, which we'll cover later on in this video. The fourth reason that you could be ovulating late is because cortisol is high. Because if your cortisol is high, that means that you're stressed out. And yes, of course, that could be due to life, or because you're busy, or because of relationship issues. Financial matters is a big one, obviously. Jobs, family. But it doesn't always need to be emotional stress. It can also be physical stress, because it has the same effect on your body. And examples of physical stress are you getting sick. So just the simple cold could even bring up your cortisol, which would explain why you would ovulate late that cycle. But it could also be that you have an ongoing inflammation in your body. Maybe you have an autoimmune disease that you do or don't know about. Or it could be that you're struggling with your sugar balance. So if you're pre-diabetic or you have insulin resistance, then that is an issue for sure. Because if your sugar drops too much, then that is stress for your body, because your body basically thinks that you're starving. So also, when you are crash dieting, or if you struggle with anorexia or bulimia, then those are also reasons for your body to be stressed out, and then as a result, not ovulate at all, or in the best case scenario, ovulate late. And the way that this impacts your fertility and your ovulation is that in order for your body to produce cortisol, it uses pregnenolone. But pregnenolone is also used to produce estrogen and progesterone, which is what you need for ovulation, right? At least the estrogen you need for ovulation, and progesterone is what you produce after ovulation. Now, if your body is stressed out and it needs to produce cortisol, it's going to do that first and not care about the sex hormones. So make sure to get your stress down, whatever the cause is. Reason number five for late ovulation could be high TSH. And if you have high TSH, that says something about your thyroid or your anterior pituitary gland. And I mentioned the anterior pituitary gland earlier when I talked about prolactin. Now, if your anterior pituitary gland is a little bit in overdrive, that could mean that it is producing too much TSH and yelling at your thyroid to do its job when your thyroid is fine. However, it's also possible that your thyroid is sluggish and you struggle with hypothyroidism, and you are not producing enough thyroid hormones, and that is telling your anterior pituitary gland to keep yelling at your thyroid to do its job, even though it's not really able to do it. The problem with high TSH in itself is that that brings up prolactin, and I mentioned earlier that that interferes with ovulation. But generally speaking, hypothyroidism is also an issue for ovulation and for fertility because it just means that your metabolism isn't right. And this is often a result of stress as well. So if you've been living with high cortisol levels for a long period of time, your thyroid will actually be your friend. And as I always say, slam the brakes, make you tired, cold, and grow fat so that maybe you will hibernate and take a break so that you can restore brain cortisol levels down and get back to your non-stressy self. However, there are also obviously autoimmune reasons for hypothyroidism, so it's always worthwhile to get this checked out, but it's also good to know if you have symptoms that are of hypothyroidism that it's not always a matter of your thyroid is sick. It could just be a result of long-term stress and that you can take care of at home yourself. And then there's one last reason, reason number six, that I want to cover today for late ovulation, and that is if you are taking anti-inflammatory medication. Studies have shown that if you take that, that definitely can affect your ovulation. You may ovulate late, or again, not at all. So consider if you really need to be taking these anti-inflammatories, if you're on those, and otherwise discuss it with your doctor if they have been prescribed rather than that they're over the counter. So now you know the most common reasons for late ovulation or lack of ovulation, and some of them are chronic, but you see that some are also temporary and can easily be fixed by you, especially when it has something to do with just a temporary illness or with stress that you can get on top of. And if you are not ovulating late, but you're ovulating early and you want to know why, let me know in the comments that that's the next video you would like to see. If you want to learn more about charting and interpreting your charts, make sure to click on the playlist on your screen right now. And if you aren't already a subscriber, but you're interested in more videos on charting, fertility, boosting naturally, and hormones, then make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell as well, because I bring out new videos every Thursday. And in the meantime, see you in the next video. Bye.